Hello, in this video I am going to demonstrate Cournot. Cournot is a model where we have, in this case, two firms producing identical goods. They're competing by setting output, and this output is set simultaneously. So the market demand conditions are given by this inverse demand of price equals 100 minus Q, where Q equals the output of firm 1 plus the output of firm 2. So I'm going to go ahead and make that substitution here into the inverse demand. I'm going to rewrite it now as 100 minus Q1 plus Q2. And let me just simplify that. And we get the following expression. So from firm 1's perspective, total revenue is price times the amount of output produced by firm 1. So let's get firm 1's total revenue equation. What you see I did here was substituting the inverse demand equation in for P, and that's going to be all then multiplied through by the output of firm 1, Q subscript 1. This will simplify down to 100 Q subscript 1 minus Q subscript 1 squared minus Q subscript 1 times Q subscript 2. We want to get marginal revenue because it's going to eventually lead into profit maximization. Now, let me put some subscripts here on the total revenue and marginal revenue. To get marginal revenue, we will take the derivative of the total revenue function with respect to the output of firm 1, technically a partial derivative, and we get the following result. Okay. And let me just rewrite that over here. So we got marginal revenue. Now we're going to set firm 1's marginal revenue equal to marginal cost. Marginal cost will come from the total cost equation. Each firm, we're assuming, has the same cost structure. And we get a marginal cost of 40. So let me go on to the next page, and I'm just going to set marginal revenue equal to marginal cost. And now after we do this, we want to simplify this down and solve for the output of firm 1. And there you go. You have the output of firm 1 equaling 30 minus the output, or half the output, of firm 2. This is referred to as firm 1's reaction function. Okay, it gives us the best response for firm 1 in terms of output for any output level decided by firm 2. Okay, now our next step is to do basically the same thing, but now from firm 2's perspective. And maybe I'll go up here. So from firm 2's perspective, firm 2 is facing the same market demand conditions. So nothing has changed here. We want to get firm 2's total revenue. So just like we did for firm 1, we're going to substitute the inverse demand into the total revenue equation for P, but this time we're going to multiply by firm 2's output, the amount of output sold by firm 2. We are going to simplify this down. And we get the following result. To get marginal revenue, I'm going to take the partial derivative of the total revenue function with respect to the output of firm 2, and we get 100 minus 2q subscript 2 minus q subscript 1. Let me go on to the next page, but what we're going to do on the next page is just simply set marginal revenue for firm 2 equal to marginal cost. And doing that, we get the following result. And this will simplify nicely to something that looks like this. And what we got here is firm 2's reaction function. And let me just remind us, firm 1's reaction function is basically the mirror image of firm 2's reaction function. And this will always be a property here of Cournot if you're dealing with identical cost structures for both firms. Now we got two reaction functions. What we want to do is to substitute one of these reaction functions into the other. So what I'll do is I'll take the reaction function for firm 1 and I'll substitute into it the reaction function of firm 2. And now we're going to simplify this. And we get 3/4 the output of firm 1 equals 15. And in this case, we are going to get 60 divided by 3, or 20 units of output. So firm 1 should produce 20 units of output in order to maximize profits in this Cournot competition. For firm 2, to get firm 2's output, we can just simply take this 20 here and plug it into firm 2's reaction function. So doing that, let me go over here then. Firm 1 wants to produce 20 units of output. Let's see what firm 2 wants to do. And we see that firm 2 also wants to produce 20 units of output. And this is no accident. In Cournot, once again, if you have the firms having equal cost structures, each firm will produce the same amount of output. Next thing we should get is the market price. So the market price P equals what was our inverse demand? It was 100 minus Q. And so in this case, 100 minus 40. The total industry output is Q1 plus Q2. So we get a market price of $60. And that is how you solve a Cournot problem. Let me know if you have any questions.